Motion might be the most advanced daily planner app on the market. That's right, I've reviewed Sunsama, Akiflow, and this one might be even better than all of those combined. The high level of automation and planning that you can do in Motion is pretty amazing, and that's why I'm gonna review it in this video. First of all, to get it out of the way, the pricing structure on this is premium. If you have the money to pay for it, get it. If not, don't, but enjoy the rest of this video because it's gonna be intriguing enough for you to maybe think about it if you can manage to get the thing for free somehow, or if you're willing to pay for it. And you can actually invite people to get credits given to them, and then after sending 5 invites, even if they don't sign up, you'll receive a 44% discount every month starting now on the monthly subscription until eternity. So you really do get this for a lot less if you try to give it out. What's cool here is at the start of this, it kind of brings you through a whole prompt of like, what are your working hours? You can add different days, you can change it, but I do work 9 to 5, so that pretty much works. And then I'd say I work 7 to noon. Probably these other two. I don't really work Saturdays. 7 to 3 on Sundays. So then as you'll see here, it actually brings in just that Calendly, which is the calls I had. But if I want to add more to the calendar, I pressed calendar and it added all the other ones that could exist here. So now I sort of have a actual view of how my entire calendar looks. We could change this to a day or a week view here so that I could easily add stuff to the left of this. And this is a nice little spot so that I can see like maybe what the time block should be, but then add tasks to those time blocks as well. And what's really cool here is if you go, you'll see what's coming up next on the top left over here. And with the Motion Chrome extension, you'll actually be prompted to join calls and stuff and allow you to share availability really easily with others. For example, here, when you go to the scheduler and press set up my schedule, what you can do here is you can set up your booking link so that you can make sure that it is only within your 9 to 5 work hours, or you can pick it being anytime, prevent back-to-back meetings, attendance requirements. I, for example, would put it right there. You can select the duration. I'd like to set up via Google Meet, and then this link is what it would be. So if I create a booking page, then if I went to this booking page, you'll see that it actually has different options here for you to check. So if I go here or here, I'd have the day that I selected and then the few days after that, just to see what different times I'm actually available to schedule a link with. So this actually takes over something like Calendly, which is really nice, and integrates it with your task management software. And speaking of task management, in the project and tasks section here, you can do multiple things. You could add a project, add tasks, add recurring tasks, and then in this dropdown, you'll see that it already gave you a bunch of tasks that don't have a project. This is sort of onboarding stuff. So if I made a project for onboarding, Motion onboarding, you'll see here that a project here can have subtasks be made really easily. You can choose the date, the priority, what progress it's at, and then custom labels. And as well, there's a whole notes section here, which is convenient, and you can write comments on it, which is great if you have teams. You could also share it with others or just have a My Tasks section here. So for me, I would say all this stuff is Motion onboarding. So what I could do is, as you can see, it's actually, these are all actually a part of this project. I'm just gonna open this, gonna edit this, and it can actually be moved to a different project just like that. You'll see this is down here now. And then if I complete a project by changing this to completed, you'll see that I can actually open this and complete this project. What'll happen is it'll disappear because it's auto set to active projects, but I could do completed projects or even backlog, which is another status. And then you could look through things in a Kanban board view, whether it be via general, just projects, just backlog, and you can do it by different groups. You can group by label, priority, workspace, and you can filter it as well right here. And then here in the calendar section, I can untick other parts of life. So I can just leave basically Calendly showing. And when I do Rise Productive Work, it's auto defaulted here. So then now when I go here, what I could do, I could edit one of these tasks and change the date to being Friday. Or I can go edit here and choose a different scheduled date. So I can do during work hours on Monday, press save. I'm gonna go back into the projects and tasks. You'll see that these tasks that I assigned also have a deadline now. And something really cool here is if I wanna add a random meeting to my day and I press on the calendar right here and put meeting example, go to more options. I can add video conferencing really easily. And when adding anything to your view here, when you're putting something on there, what you'll find is this actually is saying, is this a task or is this a meeting? So if I put task right here, I do example task, that'll populate right here for me. And then it will give you all the same options as you had in the other projects and tasks view. When making new something here, If I do more options and add conferencing, I could easily add a different example meeting here. You can set yourself to free or busy as well. So if I press create event, it actually figures out that it would be a meeting instead of a task. You'll see right here, it pops up as an example task in my Google Calendar and an example meeting. It's two different things. If I grab this time slot from 6 to 7 a.m. and press task here and put workout, I can create that task. And I can also press start task here, which essentially makes it recalculate when I started the task, and I'll move it on the calendar automatically like this. And then maybe I'd have to move my meeting in order to adjust. And then from here, I can fix time the task, or I can change this to do later, do as soon as possible, focus banner, backlog, or delete it. And then there's this option to have split chunks, which essentially takes a different amount of time. So it's 1 hour. What if I want to make it into 2 30-minute segments? I could press 30 minutes, press save. And then if I go to the top right and press complete task and press check off, it'll recalculate this and it will disappear. But I can always go back and show the completed tasks by going to the bottom left and ticking it off. And then when it comes to easily having recurring events, you can just go to here, press the does repeat, and then I can do a custom repeat here just like any other software. Do it every Saturday, ends, let's just say it ends next week. Just want to have it a 2 weeks in a row thing, example meeting. And then whether you want it to be a meeting or not, you do it now or you press task and then press create task. And if we go to the 20th, actually it does not do the recurring way like that. We'd have to go back here and do it for a meeting for that to actually work. Example meeting, create events. And if we go to next Saturday, it'll be right there. And when you go to projects and tasks in my tasks, you can actually add recurring tasks by going here. So if I go to recurring tasks, you can choose to fill in these two fields to auto schedule them, or you can put the certain type of status right there or add a new status. So say I want to do it once a week on Saturdays from this day, do cook dinner. If I want to be the kind of person that cooks every once in a while, and I press save here, what'll happen is if I go to my calendar, you'll see right here, what it does is it populates this once a week or specific days section right here for the recurring tasks. If I go and move it to 5 p.m., I want to move the task. If I go to next Saturday, I want to move it to 5 p.m. You can play around with whatever your recurring task situation would be. I will be honest and say there's a little bit of bugginess to the feel of this application, but it is uniquely different and has a lot of promise. If you like this video and want to see more like this, make sure to check out this one on how to improve your productivity even more.